Bhagavad-gita, as we discussed earlier, is a treatise on management, in particular managing oneself. Most of the Western management science, which we teach in universities, colleges and other institutions, in my opinion, say more about managing others. But though they mention about managing oneself, but the focus in Bhagavad-gita type of treatises in our ancient Indian literature is to begin with managing oneself. If you don't manage oneself properly, you are not eligible or capable of managing others in the life. So that is the first point which we should understand for Bhagavad Gita as we are discussing its relevance to our contemporary life. The second, Bhagavad Gita is again a greatest treatise on human psychology. It tells you how to deal with various situations of conflicts, of stresses, various situations of dilemmas, various situations when there is disturbance of peace, both in the individual and at the societal level. So it deals with the factors of human behavior and gives ways and means of dealing with the dilemmas at the individual level, at the societal level, at the national level. So we can treat it as a treatise human psychology. And related with that is the notion or the understanding that Bhagavad Gita is a great human science. You know, it tells how to have proper optimum human relations. You know, after all, what we call today as development is we are treating as only partially as economic development. But development in the holistic sense has to be concerned with not only economic development, but also social development, personality development, values development. So in that sense, Bhagavad Gita could be considered as a treatise for holistic development of man, quote unquote, mankind as a whole. So vishada, a sense of sadness, a feeling of depression, a feeling of discomfort, when you try to avoid the performance of duty, as was the situation of Arjuna, that becomes instrumentality, that becomes the means for a renowned, accomplished person like Krishna to step in and advise Arjuna as to why he should remove, he should get free from the moha and try to be motivated to perform the duty. So in the second adhyaya, tam tata kripaya vishtam ashrupurna kulekshanam vishidantamidam vakyam uvacha madhusudanaha. Sanjaya starts narrating the sequence of events. In a way, when Arjuna became Vishanna and Dhritarashtra is listening to this narration by Sanjaya, Dhritarashtra feels a little happy. Does it mean that he gave up the war and went away? But immediately Sanjaya narrates that at that moment Lord Krishna intervenes. So the first thing which Lord Krishna did, what he did is very important for our everyday life. Kutastva kashmalamidam vishame samupasthitam anarya jushtam aswargyam akirtikaram Arjuna klaibhyam asmagamah partha naitatvai upavadyate chudram hridaya daurbalyam tektvottishtha parantapa. So in this I feel four levels of conversation by Krishna or advice being given by Krishna to the treatment which Krishna is giving to the psychologically affected Arjuna. There are four stages in it. First is to rebuke him, to demolish him, his thinking. Kutastva kashmalamidam vishame samupasthitam. At this very awkward time, how did you get in this very dirty thought? Second, he does not make him feel that he is gone, he is finished. Many times we say in the house, you know, if the child does not study, say you are condemned, you are gone, you are good for nothing, go to hell, go and get yourself lost. No, don't do that. Anarya jushtam aswargyam akirtikaram. Arjuna's thoughts were extremely deplorable. Anarya jushtam. Arya jushtam, na arya jushtam, anarya jushtam. Anarya hi jushtam, anarya jushtam. There are two ways of looking at the word anarya jushtam. Jushtam means sevitam, followed by the anaryas. those who are not civilized, those who are not knowing what is right or what is wrong. And Arya means those who are, you know, we say Aryas and Dravidas, but these are all terminologies in a way created by the Western world. But Arya essentially means an respectable person who knows the Shastras, who has a deep knowledge of do's and don'ts. And Arya Jushtam means that which is followed and pursued by Aryas. No Arya Jushtam. It's not pursued by a knowledgeable and accomplished people. And secondly, Anarya Jushtam. What you are doing, going to say or wanting to do is not the one which is pursued by Anaryas, who are not very good people. So then, all right, I don't care for Aryas and Anaryas, but I get Swarga. I will be, people will say that I avoided killings of so many people, so gods will be pleased, they give me Swarga. Then you do not become eligible for Swarga also.
Early, right from the beginning, Arjuna was very kind hearted. Dronacharya asked Arjuna to bring Drupada to his presence as Drudakshina. Arjuna along with his brothers attacked Drupada and Drupada was caught. Even then Bhima was destroying the army of Drupada, but Arjuna asked him, no, we want Drupada only, he is one of our relatives, we should not destroy his army. As we have already caught Drupada, let us take him to the presence of our guru and let us hand over him to our guru, he said. And even by doing so, Dronacharya did not, he did not say any word against Arjuna for not destroying the army of Drupada. But the same kindness is continued here also, at the time of Kurukshetra.
The contexts are quite different.
Here, Krishna is Prahasanniva, as if he is, sometimes he is laughing at him.
No, laughing at him in the sense, it is a contradiction or it is in conflict with the true personality of Arjuna. See, the true personality of Arjuna was to do his job of destruction of adharma and conforming to the value system of respecting the gurus and doing what is right. But here, even though he realized that the yuddha with the adharmis like Duryodhana, Dushasana is the rightful act, he was moving away from it. So this made Lord Krishna become a little, what should I say, annoyed and humored. So why this has happened? So when he was feeling annoyed, he rebuked him fully. Anarya Jushtam Aswargyam. Then Arjuna says, I don't care for Swarga. So at least it will bring me Kirti, Akirti Karam. In all respects, what you have thought is Kashmala. A very bad thought. So you tell the child when he or she is not studying properly, or tell the juniors who are not doing their work properly in the offices, they are saying that the senior boss should not immediately write a memo that he should be dismissed. Instead of that, he should understand the reason as to why the person has got into that situation, but rebuke him. What you are doing in keeping the files unattended for days together is not correct. Because you are given the duty of attending to your duties or to the files, and child not studying has to be rebuked. He said, what you are thinking? But at the same time, don't allow even a second to make the man feel totally depressed. I would not say totally go and commit suicide, or rather that's an extreme step, but he should not be pushed to taking action on the basis of your rebuking. Immediately tell him you have the potential. So that is why he uses the word Arjuna. Now I am analyzing the slokas as to bring out the point that Bhagavad Gita is a treatment on human relations, human psychology, human conversation. How you should make conversation with each other so that you are moving ahead, moving forward for better relations, human relations, a better situation of life.
Excuse me, that we call as transactional awareness.
Oh, I see. Okay. That's very good. Yeah.
It's a very broad chapter in psychology. Uh-huh. How to move with others, how to converse with others, how to behave with others.
Yeah.
These all include
transactional psychology.
Which you are talking about.
Yes, exactly. Very good. Arjuna means who is fair complexioned in all the three worlds. He said nobody is as fair complexioned as me, and he also says that I never do anything which is subject to blemish, which is condemnable. So you have that reputation. So, many times with the child, let me take very practical examples. If the child is not studying, you rebuke him, it's not correct. But don't condemn him to be totally useless. You should allow him or encourage him to come out of the situation. You say, you are a very clever, intelligent boy. You were scoring so many marks earlier. To a junior officer, you say, you always used to clear the files, nothing kept on the table earlier. But why this has happened? Anything wrong? You know? Then, let me tell you a very personal example. When I was Director General of RIS, Research and Information System, one of the officers was becoming truant. He was not coming, and everyone said that let us give memo to him, let us give notice sort of thing, and maybe even dismiss him. I told my people, find out why he is doing like that. Then we discovered that he had no good family life, family relations. So I asked our people to bring him to my house. Then I discovered this. I talked to him for 15 minutes on his family matters and asked his wife and family people to come and discuss with him that. I tell you, I am telling you a very practical example. Next week onwards, he was very regular and his wife also pleased and he was also pleased that we get the maximum out of him. He completed his PhD from some university. So that's why Arjuna, the use of the word Arjuna is giving us this methodology of dealing with the people when you find them becoming truant. Truant means not performing their prescribed duties. Then he brings in a little humor, you know, in the talking. Klaibhyam Mahasmagam of Partha. So immediately what flashes in the mind of Arjuna? He is going to Indra's Swargaloka, trying to get the Indra Ayudhas and then Vajra Ayudha and at that time Urvasi falling in love with him, wanting to marry, and then he does not want that, and Urvasi gives him the Shapa that you become Napumsaka. Then they say it will be confined to 1 year and it will be confined to his wishes when he wants. So during Ajnatavasa that was useful, and it was a very funny situation. A great warrior becoming Brihannala, working with ladies around him and not having any emotions like a Napunsaka, and that time it was useful. So don't get into that situation. Don't you think that it brings in a humor and makes Arjuna sit up and think as to what he is doing, is going to give this impression to the world. So Krishna's skill in dealing with Arjuna right at the very beginning, after all, later on he takes him to gradually to such higher and higher levels of sophistication of philosophy. It is unbelievable. And later on Arjuna himself asks a number of profound questions which many of us would not have thought. He asks many profound questions. When we come to that, we would realize that when Arjuna is asking profound questions, Krishna feels very happy that he has been able to convert him and make him become not only a man but a superman in acting on his duties. So he gradually takes him. Klaibhyam Mahasmagam of Partha. Now while saying Partha, I have seen in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna Paramatma uses the word Partha, Kaunteya, whenever he has to show compassion and pity on him. I am sure being very close to Arjuna, he would have put his hand on the shoulders of Arjuna and said, Partha, my sister's son, don't do that. I feel very sad. Why do you? So these two slokas have all got all the approaches of human relations, of dealing with the people. Partha na etattvai upapadyate. This is not fair, this is not good. So in the word naitattvai upapadyate, he is having the tone of compassion, concern and a sort of an expectation. Then kshudram hridaya daurbalyam taktvottishta parantapa. This is like awake, arise and conquer. The message which our Vivekananda gave to the entire country, and Vivekananda also had felt depressed by the inaction, non-functionality of the Indian citizens, and after returning from America, after his very celebrated speech there, he got inspired to convert the society. He wanted to bring in a new vision, new energy, a new purposefulness in the people of the country. So he said, awake, arise, uttishtata, jagrata, prapyavaran, nibodhata. All our Upanishads are doing that. and we have forgotten Upanishads or Vedas and considered them as only ritualistic mantras, but they are telling us messages for everyday life. So, Shudram Hrudaya Daurbalyam Takto Tishtha Parantapa, then the use of Parantapa, as I said, I would like to repeat, Parantapa has two meanings, Parantapayati iti Parantapaha, you are capable of destroying the enemies of whatever kind it is, and Parantapati iti Parantapaha, you have also the capability of performing your yuddha as an arathana of Bhagavan. So, Parantapati, see tapasvi means what? Alochane. Later on, Krishna Paramatma gives us in Bhagavad Gita three types of tapas, sharirika tapas, vachika tapas, manasika tapas. So, tapas does not mean you have to go to forest, sit under the tree, go away from the society. So it tells us as to how we can practice tapas in our everyday life. So, Parantapati, he is able to perceive Paramatma everywhere and consider his yuddha as a duty and perform the yuddha as an aradhana of Paramatma for his preeti. So, that capability is there in you. You are a good warrior as a kshatriya, you are also knowing how to perform that task. So, all this is trying to induce in Arjuna a rethinking, you know, his own. I am sure the psychologists do that. They allow the patient to come up with all his problems.
Motivation.
I am very glad that we get these modern psychologist terminologies to link as to how Bhagavad Gita has to greatest treatise on psychology. So, if we put the different slokas and put the modern jargons of psychology, it can be a good textbook in psychology for.
This is all what you narrated now. It is nothing but cognitive behavior therapy, we call, sir.
That's right.
For the patients who are very much depressed, are very much anxious, are suffering from anxiety disorders, we make them rationalistic and we analyze their thinking, make them to motivate themselves from their inner innate abilities.
Exactly. This is what he does. The swabhava of Arjuna is not this one. He also accepts that little. Now, what does Arjuna say? Katam bhishma maham sankhe dronan cha madhusudana ishubhi pratiyochyami pujarhav arisudana. See the intensity and the fervor of his arguments earlier, before he gave up his Gandiva dhanus and sat down and say, I will not act. Now he has been totally mellowed. Even with one dose by Lord Krishna, the therapist, Arjuna has been mellowed. He asked the question, you ask me to fight, how can I fight with Bhishma and Drona? And look, Krishna, what are you? You are Madhusudana. You have killed Madhunamaka Daitya. Madhum Sudayati iti Madhusudana. You have killed a demon. You have killed an asura. But you are asking me to fight with Bhishmacharya and Dronacharya. Then Ishubhi Pratiyochyami. See, the Sanskrit, the words are very significant. Since we have lost touch with Sanskrit, we are not able to appreciate their, you know, inner points. Pratiyochyami. Even if they throw an arrow towards me, I cannot throw an arrow back to them. Pratiyochyami means in return. See, that is, we always say, you know, I can't retaliate. That is of a different context. But here, how do I do that? But then again, in the second verse, in second line, here again, puja arhav, then arisudana. What you have done before advising it, think properly. No, Arjuna had such a great friendship with Krishna, he could take liberty. And in any conversations of a patient or the advisor, there has to be a liberty of expression. So, Arisudana, you have killed Aris, those who have hated you, who have done wrong, you have destroyed them. But you are asking me to destroy the puja arhav. Then Gurun Ahatva hi Mahanubhavan Sreyo Bhaktum Bhaksham Apiha Loke Hatvartha Kamamstu Guru Nihayava Vunjiya Bhogan Rudhira Pradigdhan. He still is wedded to his logic that I should not be fighting. But the reasoning for that is now very much different from what he said earlier. Earlier he said, how can I kill my relatives? Now he recognizes that they are all wrongdoers. Maybe suddenly a rethinking has come in Arjuna to say that whatever arguments he gave earlier are not very but justified. Now he says, how can I kill the gurus? Guru, it is better without killing the gurus, I would go with a begging bowl and get the food and go to a ashrama and learn shastras and I can live happily. These people, Guru, I agree, they were artha kaman. See, Guru, they were going after the laukika artha. Artham kamayati iti artha kamaha. So I agree that they were wrong in doing that, but still they were gurus. They taught me guru nihaiva bhunji. And then what happens? What happens? You can kill them, but the objects, this material which I am going to use for my pleasure are rudhira pradigdhan. They are all blemished by the blood of those people. They have used that sitting there, using those palatial pleasures. How can I do that? So his whole argument is now on gurus and having an alternative other than sitting quiet. See, then he also accepts why he has come to this situation. Nachaitad vidmah kataranno gariyo yadva jayema yadivano jayehu yaneva hatva najiji vishamaha tevasthita pramukhe dhartarashtraha. You understand my dilemma. Though he is called as Vijaya, I can conquer them, but in the present moment, I am not able to know which is more probable. Katarat no gariyaha. Gariyaha means not more better. It is more probable. Which is more probable? Whether we win or they will conquer us. So, yaneva hatvana jijivishamaha, jivitumichamaha. The persons who are present in front of me, with whom I have to fight, are such people, by killing them, I will not like to live. So, te avasthitaha pramukhe dhartarashtraha. The next loka is the most profound confession of Arjuna and his readiness to receive the sermons from Lord Krishna. Thank you.